Dear Russian learners, hello and welcome to my class. This is Daria from Express Russian and I hope you enjoy learning with me. In this first lesson, we will discover such topic as Russian alphabet and Russian pronunciation. Stay tuned. And before speaking about Russian alphabet, I would like to speak about Cyrillic script. As you have noticed, Russian alphabet is based on Cyrillic script, which is quite different from Latin script. How did Cyrillic script make its way to Russia? So it was introduced into Kiev Rus. At that time, this was the territory which included Russia and Ukraine and Belarus. So it was introduced into Kiev Rus at the time of its conversion to Christianity, which was only in 988 after Jesus Christ. And the script itself is based after the scholar who created it. His name was Cyril. So he created it to translate Christian texts into the Slavic languages. The Cyrillic script is used now in many languages, both Slavic and non-Slavic. For example, such Slavic languages as Russian, Ukrainian, Belarusian, Bulgarian, Serbian, Macedonian, and Montenegrin, and non-Slavic languages such as Kazakh, Kyrgyz, Mongolian, Tiva. And this is the map of the Cyrillic script spread. As you can see, it's quite a large territory, which covers maybe 1/5 or 1/6 of the whole world. So how many people in the world speak Russian? Russian is an official language in Russia, Belarus, Kazakhstan, and Kyrgyzstan. And it is also widely spoken in Ukraine, Moldova, Latvia, and Estonia, and to a lesser extent in other ex-Soviet countries. There are over 300 million Russian speakers in the world. So you see, it's quite beneficial to learn Russian and to speak Russian. Now, let's move to Russian alphabet. So Russian alphabet contains 33 letters, out of them 21 consonants. Look at the screen and see how I pronounce them. B, V, G, D, Ж, З, К, Л, М, Н, П, Р, С, Т, Ф, Х, Ц, Ч, Ш, Щ. And another consonant, and which is sometimes called semi-vowel, Y, because its sound is close to Y, for example, мой. And what about Russian vowels? There are 10 vowels: A, E, Ы, У, О, Я, Е, Ё, Ю, И. Two letters of the Russian alphabet do not designate any sound. It means they are not pronounced on their own, but they are pronounced with the previous consonants. For example, the soft sign softens the previous consonant, and the hard sign hardens the previous consonant as well. Have you ever seen Russian cursive or handwritten Russian language? Well, you will be surprised to know that there is a handwritten variation of Russian language, which is quite different from the printed one. So the letters are written a bit more rounded. The letters are connected one with each other. I'm sure you have seen it in your language as well, in English or whatever is your mother tongue. And the good news is that in these days there are not so many documents, not so many signs written in the handwritten language, so you will not come across often. But it's good to know how the letters are written and good to just be able to recognize them if you see this text written in Russian cursive. In the video on the next slide, you will see all the Russian letters printed and cursive. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to pronounce Russian letters. On the slides, you will also see a handwritten letter. So let's start with A. A, автобус. B, банан. В виноград. Г. Груша. Д. Дом. Е. Ежевика. Ё. Ёлка. Ж. Жираф. З. Зебра. И. Игрушки. И. Йогурт. К. Кошка. Л. Лампа. М. Машина. Н. Ножницы. О. Облако. П. Поезд. Р. Река. С. Слон. Т. Тигр. У. Утка. Ф. Фотография. Х. Хлеб. Ц. Цветок. Ч. Чашка. Ш. Шарф. Щ. Щетка. Объявление. И. Сыр. Мышь. Э. Экскаватор. Ю. Юбка. Я. Яблоко.
As you are still a beginner in Russian, I understand it's quite difficult to just learn by heart all the pronunciation of all the letters and not to be lost. That's why I have created for you this quick reference guide. Be sure to refer to it when needed. Stop this video, make a screenshot and maybe print it out or write it for yourself on a piece of paper so you don't lose and don't forget.
Now that you know Russian letters, it's your turn to read. Pause the video and try to read the words on the pictures. I will do the first slide with you. Арбуз, белка, виноград, гриб, дом. Now it's your turn. So, let's see where we are. We spoke about Cyrillic script, Russian alphabet with its 33 letters, and cursive, handwritten Russian. We learned Russian letters and their closest pronunciation equivalents to the English language sounds. But letters never stay alone. In a word, they are surrounded by other letters that influence them. As you have noticed, in Russian the pronunciation is slightly different from the spelling. So two important things to keep in mind are the stress, or the emphasis, or the accent for vowels, and the influence of the surrounding letters for consonants. In short, a soft neighboring letter makes the preceding letter softer, and a voiced letter makes the preceding consonant sound stronger. But don't be afraid, you will be understood even if you pronounce the words just how they are written. But don't be surprised if you hear half sounds. I mean the letters that don't sound how they are written.
Now let's see in detail for vowel pronunciation. The stress of a word always falls on a vowel. But which one? That's a challenge, because in Russian the stress is not fixed. You may know that, for example, in French language, the stress or the accent or the emphasis falls on the last syllable. For example, merci. In Polish, the accent falls on the one but last syllable. However, for Russian words, you need to check always in the dictionary, because the stress is not fixed. So it can be in any syllable, but it's always known which syllable will be stressed, and you need to only check it in the dictionary. So all the books for beginners and all the dictionaries will have the stress mark over the letter, the vowel which is stressed, but actually normally we do not write words with accents, which is quite difficult if you are reading some other texts which are not adapted for beginners, because you will not see the accents and you will not know how to pronounce, and that's why you will need to check the word in the dictionaries. So stressed vowels are marked with acute accent, as I already said, in all the dictionaries, and words can have only one stress, except for compound words, for example, Москва река, Moscow river, девушка красавица, beautiful girl. So these are words joined by a hyphen. And a very important thing to know here, that while stressed vowels are pronounced rather distinctly, unstressed vowels undergo pronunciation changes, so-called voice reduction. Let's see, the example mama. Ma-ma. There are two syllables, two vowels. The first vowel, a, is stressed mama, and it's pronounced with full sound, but the second one is not stressed. So you still hear R, but it's kind of half sound. It's A, but with a reduced sound of A. Now, let's see about unstressed O. This is a classic example of voice reduction for vowels. So the farther the vowel is from the stress, the less sound it gets. Vowel O in the word молоко is pronounced, all the vowels O are pronounced differently. The first O is the farthest from the stressed syllable, so it's almost not pronounced at all. М, молоко. The second О is reduced to almost А, sound like in under or after. And the third О is fully pronounced because it appears in the stressed syllable. Unstressed Е and Я. Similar voice reduction happens to vowels Е and Я in unstressed positions. They sound close to E. For example, ведро, it's written ведро, but you pronounce ведро. See, the accent falls on O, so it's the next syllable, not the syllable with E. That's why we write V, but we pronounce V, ведро. Темно, we write темно, but we pronounce темно. Интересный. There is a written е, интересный, but we pronounce интересный. Язык. Also, the stress falls on ы, not on я. That's why we pronounce я as и. Январь. Январь is also я here is unstressed. That's why we don't pronounce it fully. We say и. Other vowels in unstressed syllables undergo minor reductions, unnoticeable for foreigners and even for many native speakers. Generally, they are pronounced just like a weaker version of themselves. I have already mentioned that Russians do not write with accents. Accents are only written over text if it's a book for beginners or it's a dictionary. If a word has only one syllable, for example, зуб, хлеб, the accent mark is not typed, because it's clear that only this one is the only one syllable, it will be stressed.
Letter Y, if present in the word, is always stressed, but no stress or accent mark is written over it. Placing the stress on the correct syllable is very important. Mistaken word stress sounds not only strange, but it can change the whole meaning of the word.
In any language studies, there is such a notion as homonyms. These are two words that are written the same way, but pronounced differently, and they mean different things. And the only difference in them is the accent. And of course, the meaning.
Now we are moving into consonant pronunciation. So, with few exceptions, Russian consonants can be pronounced either soft or hard, voiced or voiceless, depending on the type of letter that follows them or precedes them. Voiced and voiceless letters or consonants have pairs. Voiced consonants devocalize, or in other words, their voiceless pair is pronounced instead of them when they are the last letter in a word, for example, zup, хлеб, Иванов, or they are followed by another voiceless consonant, for example, сладкий. You see, d is voiced consonant and k is voiceless, but we cannot say сладкий because k will influence d. That's why instead of d we will pronounce t, сладкий. That's why D lost its voice, and instead of her voiceless pair is pronounced T instead of D. In Ложка, the same story, K is voiceless, it influences Ж. That's why we cannot say Ложка, we say Ложка, it's just more convenient. Под столом, С influences Д, that's why we cannot say под, we say под. Instead of d.
And to finish off our lesson, I would like to give you some phrases which you can use to introduce yourself.
Привет, здравствуйте, доброе утро, добрый вечер. Depending on the situation, you can use them. Меня зовут Тарья. Приятно познакомиться. Рада вас видеть.
Now it's your turn. You can type your introduction into the group messages, or you can record a voice message.
Dear students, I am very happy to see you in my group today. I hope you found today's information useful. If it seems like too much for you, don't worry. Listen to this lesson again, pause, make notes, and ask questions. Bye for now.